Here with boxing star Chris Van Heerden. He's become worldwide famous just recently. He was a boxing champion, 147 division, but he just sparred Conor McGregor. The whole world went crazy. Tell me about it. It just happened a couple days ago. You showed up at the gym. Did they tell you who you're going to spar, or it just happened?
No, I got off a plane from South Africa, got back from holiday, got to the gym, and I was told there's someone that's on their way and they need sparring. Could I wait? So I waited, and Conor McGregor walked in.
And what was your first... Did you know who he was?
Yes. All right. Obviously, I knew who Conor McGregor was, and I was excited, man.
You were like, I'm about to kick his ass, you know, huh?
We got questions as a boxer and MMA fighters. We always got that argument where we go, a stand-up MMA fighter versus a stand-up boxer will give him trouble. So I have that question, and when they asked me if I would spar Conor, my first reaction was, hell yes. I thought it would be the same day. I still wanted to go home and get my gloves. And I was like, tomorrow. So I was excited, and
You guys went 6 rounds.
Yes.
I have a lot of questions to ask you. On a scale of 1 to 10, how do you rate Conor McGregor's power?
Oh, with 16-ounce gloves, I wasn't fazed at all.
But with 8-ounce gloves,
4-ounce gloves with mitts, it's a whole different story. One punch. Look, Conor knows how to use his hands. Conor's probably active as a fighter, the biggest fighting name out there, because Mayweather is retired. So active, Conor is possibly the biggest fight name out there at the moment. And the man knows how to use his hands. So it's not like he's a bum. He knows how to fight.
Chris, how do you rate his speed? Because you have very good speed.
You know what is good? Conor's got good precision. His timing. That little bit of timing, he's very good at that. I would say his best punch is his counter left. And that's it. You know, his timing and precision is very good.
Going 6 rounds with Conor McGregor, what did you learn from that experience?
That a boxer would beat an MMA fighter. Professional boxer beats a professional MMA fighter in a stand-up game any day. I remember, I just got off a plane. I haven't been in the gym for 1 month. That is the first time I laced up gloves. And I wanted to prove to myself that no stand-up MMA fighter can go with a stand-up professional fighter.
Conor McGregor's watching this and he's going to say, you know what, Chris Van Heerden? Let's do it again. No excuses. You train for a few weeks and get back in there. What would happen?
Oh, of course, any day. But listen, like I said, I'm taking nothing away from Conor. Okay?
He's very talented.
He's a champion. Yeah. Look, the man is good. I've learned a lot sparring with him. That's what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is, we all have that question. Conor's game is MMA. That is where no boxer should step in an octagon with Conor, because that's Conor's game. But the same thing applies to no MMA fighter has nothing to lose in a boxing ring. That's just what I'm saying.
Floyd Mayweather, Conor McGregor said initially offered him $7 million. Now it sounds like Mayweather's offering him $50 million. He wants $100 million. Break down the fight. Mayweather-McGregor, how big of a fight is it? And who do you think wins?
Mayweather wins. There's no doubt about it. Mayweather, who beats Mayweather? Mayweather is the best. And
TBE, as they say.
TBE, he's the best. Mayweather is the absolute best. And it would be... my opinion, it would be a one-sided fight. But take nothing away from Conor. It takes one punch. We all know that in the fight world. It takes one punch. And can Conor land a punch? Yes, he can land a punch.
But not on Floyd.
Not on Floyd.
49 have tried, including 26 boxing champions. Unless Floyd aged or takes him too lightly.
Not on Floyd.
He won't be able. Does Floyd stop him?
Yes.
Floyd will knock him out?
Yes.
What round?
Well, it depends on how Floyd feels. If Floyd feels like playing around and toying, that's up to Floyd. But Floyd can end it very quickly because of who Floyd is. Floyd is TBE.
Paulie Malignaggi told me yesterday that he beats Conor McGregor in boxing.
Yes.
Did he stop him?
I don't know about stoppage. Conor's tough. He's there to fight. He loves fighting. That is in him.
Tough dude.
But Paulie beats Conor.
You just said you learned stuff from sparring McGregor. You as a professional fighter, as a former champion, what have you learned from McGregor?
Well, one, he's a prof. Don't underestimate no one. You know, don't underestimate, even if you're MMA fighter. I didn't know that Conor's background was amateur boxing.
Yeah, he was really good in Ireland.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
I
could have told you that. You should have called me.
I never knew that, but I could immediately see that. And then he knows how to use his hands. Don't underestimate no one. He's got a good counter. I hate fighting southpaws. That's just it. I'm a southpaw, but I hate fighting southpaws. I've learned that, you know what? Don't underestimate no one. Even if it's an MMA fighter, don't underestimate it. Conor's got good precision, good timing, and it's really good.
Floyd Mayweather, Robert Guerrero's a southpaw. Zab Judah's a southpaw. A lot of the fighters that Mayweather face when they're southpaw, he does pretty good with them.
No, that's Mayweather. That's who we're talking about. That's why I said there's no way in this lifetime that Conor McGregor beats Floyd in a boxing match. No ways.
What about the personality? When you sparred, did Conor McGregor talk any shit? Did he say anything funny?
What a humble, what a nice gent.
He didn't say nothing like, hey, look at those shoes, or like nothing?
No, he's just such a cool guy. I was surprised how cool Conor is, and that's, I've got so much respect for him. He is one hell of a nice guy.
He's a superstar, but he does his work ethic.
Nice guy. Man, he was a hell of a nice guy.
A lot of people saw the sparring. Some people criticized him. Some people criticized you. I don't know if you saw any of that. You're a star and you're a fighter, Chrissy. You're used to it already. Did you laugh when you saw the comments?
I laughed at it because no one knows. Like I said, I just got off a plane. No one knows. And two, it's sparring.
You're not trying to kill anybody.
It's sparring.
It's not fighting.
We're out
there.
It's not a fight. It's sparring. We're just learning off each other. We're moving around. That's what it's about. It's not about getting in there and show attitude of beating up anyone. That's why I said it's sparring. I just got off a plane. That's the first time I laced up gloves since my fight on April 16th. I'm over the people commenting.
All right, to all the viewers watching this, McGregor Mayweather might happen in the end of the year, like December 31st. What do you tell everybody about that fight? You've been in the ring with Conor.
It's exciting. I think everyone wants to see it because the argument is always there between an MMA fighter and a professional boxer. The argument is always there. We are better. No, we are better. It's a thing. So now that we have the opportunity to prove that in a boxing ring, a boxer will always come out number one. We've got that opportunity.
Chris, tell everyone where to follow you on Twitter and Instagram.
Twitter at the Heat 001. Instagram, Chris Van Heerden. Follow me, get behind me. We're coming back.
Chris, common spelling, Van, V-A-N, Heerden, H-E-E-R-D-E-N.
That's it,
Chris. Stay tuned. Chris Van Heerden, all the way from South Africa. Facebook.com and Melissa back reporting. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. FaceNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekback.